Hello friends, Heidi here from Rain Country. God is good all the time. And today I'm going to show you how you can make your own dairy-free or vegan white sauce that can be used in various different things. And I do have a video out on the many uses for white sauce, and that's part of my Kitchen Tips and Tricks series. I will go ahead and link to that video below. So once you understand the basics of making a white sauce, then you can take it from there and figure out what you're going to do, because a white sauce is used as a base in making pot pies. So even if you're vegan, maybe you're not going to do a chicken pot pie, you can do a veggie pot pie. It's going to be the same idea in using this recipe instead of using dairy milk for that, or even butter like is often used in making white sauces. And today what my recipe is going to be is a fettuccine type sauce. And so I'm going to actually show you how you can do that and still get a nice fettuccine flavor and still have it be dairy free. Okay, so the first thing you want to do is you want to start with your fat, because we're going to make a roux. And the fat you're going to start with is going to be entirely up to you. Again, most roux are made starting with butter, but in this case, you can use a refined coconut oil, because you're probably not going to want to have the coconut flavor in there, or you can use avocado oil, which is what I'm going to use in this. Olive oil is a good choice too to get that more Italian flavor, but you do have to be careful with olive oil. It's not something you want to get very hot. And so when I'll use it in baking, like to add to my Italian breads and my pizza crust. But when it comes to something I'm concerned, where I'm not really sure how hot it's going to get, I play it safe and I'll go with a higher heat resistant oil like avocado or coconut. So I'm going to use about a quarter cup of oil to start with. That's actually quite a bit, but we also have to realize we're using a nut milk. We're not adding whipping cream or half and half to this. So adding some fat in other ways is a good way to get to make it a richer type sauce. So instead of doing this on my wood stove, where it's actually a beautiful day today and we're getting lots of solar collection and I don't want to have to keep walking back and forth to the other room, I'm going to go ahead and start utilizing that solar power for the season for cooking. And I'm going to be doing this on my little hot plate I have over here. So I'm going to let this oil get nice and hot, and then I'll be back to add in the thickener in just a minute. All right, now that my oil's nice and hot, let's go ahead and add my thickener. Now, if you're gluten-free, I recommend using either the arrowroot powder or the tapioca starch as your thickener. So that's a good way that you can keep it both gluten-free and dairy-free. However, what I'm going to be doing is using my own home-milled flour from the wheat grains that we have in storage. And I'll be adding a quarter cup of that to my oil. Okay, so I'm going to add that in there. I took it off the heat just to make sure it's not too hot. And I go to add this in, and you're going to want to have a whisk and whisk that in there. You can see it's browning that flour. Now, I don't want this to get too brown because of the kind of sauce that I'm going to make. However, this is how you can make a good brown gravy too. And this is going to have a little browner color to it anyway, since it's whole wheat. But it is a white wheat, so it's not as brown as your red wheat. So that's already getting pretty thick without it even being on the heat. So I'm going to turn down the heat, and I'm going to go ahead and add my nut milks to this. Now I have two different nut milks here. Here is the rest of my almond milk that I had made previously, but yesterday I made up a batch of Brazil and hazelnut milk, so I'll be using that too. So let me add the last of this. Hear it sizzling in there. And I just realized I forgot to put the onions in there. Before you add your milk, it's a good idea if you're going to add any vegetables for flavor like onions and garlic, especially if they're fresh. Now's a good time to add them in with the flour and the oil and let them brown a little bit first. And I totally spaced it, so I'm sorry about that. But we'll go ahead and add some now. I'm going to be using the Mother Earth products, dehydrated onions. And at least those will still get rehydrated by the milk. I'm also going to add in some garlic. Now remember, we're going with an Italian flavor here, so whatever spices and herbs you're going to add is going to be completely up to you, especially if you're going to use this sauce for something different. You may just want to keep it completely plain. Oh yeah, this would be a good one for biscuits and gravy. That was what I was trying to think of before. I'm also going to add a pinch of basil, a little bit of rosemary. You don't want to go too high on the rosemary. Lavender leaves would be another great option in this. And golden oregano. So instead of using the regular Mediterranean oregano that I grow, I'm going to be adding the golden oregano that I grow. I love them both. The golden oregano has a slightly sweeter and more mild flavor than your Mediterranean oregano does. Oh, it has a wonderful smell too. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and turn the heat back up a little bit and let that thicken some more, and then I'm going to add in my milk accordingly. I know I'm going to need more than that because I'm trying to make enough for both me and Patrick for dinner tonight. And I think I might make this a seafood fettuccine. You know, if you're not vegan, and adding some kind of meat to this, such as chicken or turkey. My favorite is either chicken when I'm doing this or some kind of seafood. So I have some steelhead we're trying to work through in the freezer. I've got it thawing out right now, and then I'm going to be cutting up and adding it to this. You can add a whole bunch of various types of seafood to it if you want, if you wanted a mix, or you can just leave it plain and not add any meat to it at all. We usually just like to add meat to it. It adds a little bit of flavor and more bulk to it all in general, but sometimes if I'm making the fettuccine more as a side dish and not a main dish, then I'll leave the meat out of it. Again, it's obviously going to be entirely up to you. All right, this is about done. I did add some more milk, and then I went ahead and added another pinch of each of my herbs because, well, we like a lot of flavor. And I also forgot to add a little bit of black pepper and some salt. you need at least the salt. You can leave out the black pepper if you want, but we love black pepper in our fettuccine. So about a half teaspoon, maybe a little bit better, of that, of some, I think this is the Redmond Real Salt I've got right here. And stir that in. And then the other thing I like to add to every single one of my dinners, pretty much, I can't think of one thing off the top of my head that I don't add my mixed greens blend to, and that's what I'm going to put in there. And this is all kinds of various greens that come out of my garden, from dandelion leaves to nettle and all kinds of goodies. And if you're new and you're interested in that, it does change up a little bit every year, but I'll go ahead and link to a video down below. I think from 2018 was the last one I put out. Okay, so I can turn this heat off. And we'll move that off to the side. And then, to add something to get that cheese-like flavor, like you're going to get from Parmesan cheese, then you can add in some nutritional yeast flakes. And I'll go ahead and link down below in the description box of the ones I get. I get them through the Subscribe and Save program, so I can save even more on those. And it might be 15%, but it might have changed since then. But I'm going to be saving at least 5%. So how much you put in is going to be entirely up to you. It's depending on how cheesy you want that flavor to be. But the nutritional yeast flakes are just really good for you anyway, because they're loaded in B vitamins and other goodness. And if you're dairy-free or you're vegan, if you're not already stocking up on your nutritional yeast flakes, then you should be doing that, because they're good for you and they can really, there's so much you can do. It's what I use when I make my vegan cheese out of the pecans and cashews. Okay, so there we go. The sauce is ready for later when I go to put it over whatever noodles I'm going to serve. I haven't decided what shape I'm going to use, but they're going to be coming from food storage. I do make my own noodles as well, and fettuccine noodles are the easiest ones to make. And I have a video on that if you're interested from a couple years ago. I'll link down below. But I'm not going to be making them from scratch. I'm going to be taking them from our food storage, and I probably won't be using fettuccine-shaped noodles. Oh, and I forgot to say, I didn't actually end up using all of that milk. Again, this is just for the two of us, so I don't need a whole bunch. But again, if you're going to make this for a bigger family, more than just two people, then I'd recommend at least doubling the amount that I did here. And here's another option too. If you're gluten-free, some of you may have found, or especially if you're grain-free altogether, I have found, some people like them and some people don't, but I have found the shirataki noodles to be a pretty good option. And in this photo right here, these are the ones I used in this particular, that was also a fettuccine sauce I made there. And you would have seen that in my last video. The noodles I have that on are the shirataki fettuccine noodles. And I find them to be quite good. You know, if you add the right kind of sauces and seasonings, I think they're really good. There's just a trick to it. You want to make sure you rinse them good and drain them good before you use them. And then you put them in a dry pan. I always put them in a cast iron skillet and then cook out all the water that will also heat it through, but get all the excess liquid out before you add whatever it is you're going to add to it. So that's one option. And I'll link to the ones that I've bought and used right down below. I actually have quite a bit in my food storage and they last for a very long time. I've had them for a couple years and they're still good. They haven't gone bad. Just keeping them stored in the package they came in. But since I'm not going to be making dinner until later, I like to shoot my videos early in the day just to get them done and get all my equipment put away. So what I'll be doing is adding in the steelhead later and then heating it through and making sure that the steelhead gets fully cooked and then cooking up my noodles. And so since I'll be doing that later, I'll go ahead and show you some images right here of how my dairy-free fettuccine sauce looks. And again, remember that you can take this basic recipe and then use it in just about anything that you would use something like a cream of mushroom soup or a cream of celery soup or whatever kind of cream of soup that people like to buy and use as a base for making gravies and sauces and casseroles like a tuna noodle casserole. This can be used in that. It can be a dairy-free option to use in something like that. You just, and I have a recipe on a cream of mushroom sauce. That one's not vegan, but take this and then go with that and combine them together and then you can have something that's completely dairy-free for that. And also please remember to share this with people that you know might appreciate this information because they're either vegan or they have to be dairy-free for various health reasons. All right, well I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching. Take care and God bless.